أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وأطهر المرسلين، شفيع المذنبين وحبيب رب العالمين محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء، ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the compassionate, the most merciful, all praise is due to Allah. We bear witness that no one is worthy of worship but Allah, and we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is indeed his final messenger. The best of speech is the book of Allah, and the best of guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya ahbaba Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallamu alayhi. زار نبينا صلى الله عليه وسلم أحد أصحابه وقد كان مريضا، فدخل عليه فقال الصحابي: ليتني أموت. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: تتمنى الموت وأنا عندك؟ It was said that one time the Prophet peace be upon him visited one of his companions who was not feeling well. And when he got to him, the man, being just so overwhelmed and burdened with his sickness, he said, Messenger of Allah, I wish I was dead. The Prophet said to him, you wish for death, even though I am in your presence? تتمنى الموت وأنا عندك. And subhanAllah, part of the teachings of Islam, and we will continue the story inshaAllah, but part of the teachings of Islam is that life is beautiful. And as believers, enjoy life, keeping in mind that this is not a permanent place. Moreover, do not actively seek death. Not only that, but do not even wish for it. So the Prophet, peace be upon him, said to the man he taught him, he said, لا تقل هذا, don't say this, but I have something better for you to teach. I'll teach you something better than what you're saying right now. قل اللهم بعلمك الغيب وقدرتك على الخلق احينا ما كانت الحياة خيرا لنا وتوفنا ما كانت الوفاة خيرا لنا. صلوا على رسول الله. هذا كلام جميل. The Messenger of Allah said, don't say this. Let me give you an alternative. Rather, you should say, oh Allah, by your knowledge of the unseen,
O Allah, by your capability and ability over your creatures. O Allah, extend in my life so long that living is good for me. And O Allah, put an end to my life so long that death is what is best for me. So even at that point, said, do not seek it, do not wish for it, but leave it up to Allah. Say, Allah, this is so difficult, I can't do this anymore. O Allah, extend in my life because you know the unseen. Maybe better days are coming my way. Maybe brighter days are coming my way. But right now, this is too gloomy for me. I cannot handle this. But Allah, you know that living is good for me, extend in my life. And O Allah, because you know the unseen. If this doom and gloom is going to continue with me, and you know that death is what is best for me, O Allah, put an end to my life. So we are even taught that don't wish for it, even when it becomes difficult, when life becomes challenging, don't wish for death, but rather take your prayers to Allah. And subhanAllah, not only do we not wish for death, we are forbidden also from committing suicide and bringing an end to our life. And I beg your indulgence. You know, when I came here back in the 80s, in the mid-80s, we went to school and the teacher insisted, oh, you must watch TV. This is how you pick up your good English. This is how you make your English good. So we would watch TV. And we had this program, you come home and you watch this show to this show to this show. Mind you, very young, very impressionable. You know, you'd be watching all these shows. And one of my favorite shows, one that I used to like, was a show called Growing Pains. Maybe those of you who are around my age know what I'm talking about. So Growing Pains is this innocent show, you know, where the stars were people around my age, and we would be watching it and we would wait for it, and that was the program every now and then. Few days back, I'm looking into the news, and I hear that one of the stars in the show just committed suicide. A 41-year-old young man, very popular in the show, Bonner, Andrew Kane. Few days back, he was so depressed, the man took his life, his own life away. And subhanAllah, in our minds, you know, celebrities are not supposed to commit suicide. Of all people, this man was a comedian. He was laughing all day long and making other people laugh all day long. He's rich. He's famous. These people are not supposed to commit suicide. The older you get, the richer you are, the more famous you become, the more important roles you play in the movies and in the sitcoms. So these people are not supposed to be committing suicide. And I hear that this young man has been battling depression for a long time. So a few days back, he decided to take his own life away. That was sad. Subhanallah, that was sad. But it also highlights a serious problem that is taking place in the world today. Give you an example. Did you know that every 40 seconds in the world, somebody is committing suicide? In the US here, every 17 seconds, a person is attempting to commit suicide. Suicide is the 10th leading cause of death in the US. But what is more alarming, that suicide is the third leading cause of death amongst adolescents. People who are between the ages of 15 and 24, the third leading cause for their death is suicide. Young people taking their lives away. And again, we would be thinking, of all people, young people are not supposed to be taking their lives away. These are too young to be doing this. This is time to enjoy life. But yet, it is the third leading cause of death amongst adolescents and teenagers. And wallahi, I kid you not, do not think that the Muslim community is shielded from this. We've got to be realistic. People are depressed, and this is not to celebrate depression. But that is the reality. And part of the reason is the many myths that we have about depression. So for example, you come to people and say, I'm depressed. There is something wrong with your iman, man. Your iman is weak. That is why you're depressed. Because believers, righteous people, are not supposed to be depressed. Ya Khwani, that's a lie. That is a lie. When we tell people this, that is a lie. So the person is coming to you, telling you that I'm feeling depressed, hoping that you cheer them up, you make them even feel more guilty and more terrible for speaking to you. I tell you, because of your depression, you have weak iman. تأمل معي في كلام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. ما أصاب المؤمن من هم ولا حزن ولا نصب ولا وصب حتى الشوكة يشاكها إلا كفر الله بها ذنوبه كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. See that anything that befalls a believer. وتأمل معي في كلمة المؤمن. ما أصاب المؤمن من هم. المؤمن يصاب بالهم. So the Prophet peace be upon him said, any calamity, any the minutest calamity that befalls on a believer, be it grief, be it worry, be it sadness, be it sickness. So a believer is prone to being depressed. So when somebody says, I am depressed, please, I beg you, do not say there is something wrong with your iman. Because you're lying to them and you're lying to yourself, and that's a misconception. And here Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us that a believer may go through depression. So iman does not necessarily prevent depression. But what iman does is that it prevents the potential consequences of depression. Going into despair. Iman comes on the way and says, no, you cannot go into despair. Going into the state of hopelessness. Iman comes in though and says, you cannot be hopeless. You're a believer. Remember, Allah is in charge. So number one, depression is not because of lack of iman. Or sometimes we say that a person is depressed because they're weak. So even your iman is weak, or you are weak. Wallahi, that's not true. Because good, strong people may also become depressed. And here again, we make people feel guilty. So you're depressed either because your iman is bad or because you yourself, you are weak. And wallahi, that is not the case. What real depression means is that the challenges that you have all outweigh the resources that you have. You just cannot cope with the burden that you have, and you don't have enough resources to cope with them. So the challenges outweigh your resources. That is really what it means. And when I say this, I am not talking about, you know, simplifying the issue. But depression is a serious disorder that needs to be attended to. And we don't make people feel bad because of this. Something else. When young people come to us and tell us that they're depressed, please take this very seriously. Sometimes people say, well, you know how teenagers are, they're just moody. One day they're this way and one day they're this way. Take it very serious. Especially if somebody comes and tells you, oh, I don't think life is worth living anymore. Or that I am thinking of doing something to myself. Please take this very serious. We had a young girl in our community here. She went to her father and she said, Dad, I am depressed. And the father was so upset. He said, depression is not a word that we use in this house. I don't want to hear this word used in this house anymore. And the man went well. Wallahi, he's a good man, meaning well. What he really meant is to have a snap out of it. Encouraging her by saying that depression is not a word that we use in this house. Now, since she cannot say this, she was so overwhelmed that she started cutting herself, using a knife and a razor, cutting herself. Because that was the only way for her to express all these boiling emotions in herself. Don't do that. Take it serious. When people share this with us, means that they really have a problem and they're looking for somebody to help them. One time the Prophet, peace be upon him, comes to the masjid. And he finds a man by the name of Abu Umama. Abu Umama is sitting in the masjid and he is just all depressed. And it was not time for prayers. And you know the way that the Prophet went to his house is that he goes through the masjid to go to his house. So he comes in and he finds Abu Umama sitting in the masjid, says, Abu Umama, what's wrong? مَا لَلِي أَجْلَسَكَ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ فِي غَيْرِ وَقْتِ صَلَاةِ What are you doing in the masjid even though it's not time to pray? And the man looked at the Prophet ﷺ and as we say, he opened his heart. He said, Ya Rasulullah, duyunun ahammat. He said, Messenger of Allah, I am just burdened with debts. Debts here and debts there and loans here and loans there. What does the Prophet ﷺ say? You're a weak iman. You're a weak man. Why did you borrow the money to begin with? Why did you do that? Said, Mama, let me teach you something, some prayers that you can say. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teaches him this beautiful dua. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-hammi wal-hazan wa a'udhu bika min al-'ajzi wal-kasal wa a'udhu bika min al-bukhli wal-jubn. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from anxiety and grief. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from laziness or incapacitation. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from debt and debts and what have you. But here the Prophet peace be upon him murdered the man. And the man was not bashed because he shared his anxiety and his burdens with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that is very important for us to keep. And nowadays, subhanAllah, there are many challenges. They say that the reason why men become depressed versus the reason why women become depressed, two different things. Say that men become depressed when they feel that they are useless. Somebody loses their job. I haven't had a job for 2 years. I've been laid off. And life is very difficult. The beginning of the month is becoming a challenge for me. I used up all my savings. I took all the loans. I maxed out on my credit cards. And now the beginning of the month is a very stressful time for me because I don't even know where I'll be getting the rent from. People saying that, I haven't had a job for so long, I can't even look my wife in the eye or look my children in the eye. I don't know where to go, I don't know what to do. Women feel depressed when they're not feeling valued or appreciated or they're not being given the proper attention. That leads them into depression. But the point is, once we know something like this, we can encourage each other. You know, you've worked for very hard all of your life. You know, these are times, inshallah, they will pass by. But the point is, let's not, in addition to the challenges that we have, tear each other apart. You're depressed because you're weak. You're depressed because you don't have the proper iman. We can't do this, brothers and sisters. At that point, we become the architects of the demise of one another. We tear each other down. We crush each other's spirits. And that is not acceptable. وَعَلَّمَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ أَنَّ الْفَأْلَ حُسْنُ الْقُلْبِ. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, taught that to be optimistic is the best of character. These are difficult times. And do not belittle the difficulty of the situation. You know, sometimes we think that we can give people a, you know, what you call pep talk. You know, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. Well, that's really nice. It sounds very cute. But it's been so tough and I have not been going anywhere. So don't you fool me with these words. It may not work. When the going gets tough, the tough get going. Tough times don't last, but tough people do. I'm trying to tough it out, but it's not going anywhere. You know, jokingly, واحد شخص صاحبه قال لي يا انت لسه حي ترزق قال له انا حي ولكني لا ارزق. He said that you may be doing this, we may be giving this pep talk, but it does not work with people. So the point is, do not belittle that. Now I'll keep you in my prayers, inshallah. But also what is beautiful about this is community coming together. Community coming together. This is where we need people to say, you know what, alhamdulillah, Allah has given me something. We're going to start, you know, a project. Help the needy. People who have been donating to the masjid now are coming to the masjid saying that, you know, I really don't have money to pay for rent. Wallahi, these are people in our community. These are people in Orange County. One day, mashallah, Allah has blessed them. And Allah has given them. And these were people who were coming to donate to the masjid. And now these people are coming to the masjid saying, I can't do this anymore. I need help. But then it's when the community comes together, that is when we can make a difference. If you are working and you know that your company is hiring, please let other people know. You know what, why don't you come and just, you know, come and apply at my company. They're hiring. I will say a few words on your behalf. I will help out. If you yourself, Allah has blessed you, and even though you're doing your own things and you can do it yourself, but you can afford hiring somebody, please hire somebody. Subhanallah, Abdullah ibn Mubarak. They say that he was a rich man. But then around him there was so much unemployment going on. And he wanted to do something to the people. So what does he say? He said that he's hiring. So all people come to him and they said, well, what do you need us to do? He said, I have so much dates on my trees, I need people to eat it and then give me the pits, the seeds, and I will buy it from you. So the people came to his garden and they start eating. They would collect the pits and he would come and he would, they would go and he would buy them from it. He would buy the pits from the people. Why is that? But that was his way of saying, you know what? I know what is going on and I will do my best to help out. And subhanAllah, they say, the narrators of the story, people knew what he was doing and they were laughing as they were doing it. Simply somebody saying that I recognize the problem and I would like to do something about it. But that is how communities come together. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save all the people who are going through depression, Ya Rabbil Alameen, and alleviate the difficulties of all the people who are going through difficulties. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على رسوله المصطفى وعلى من بأثاره اقتفى. Two more points إن شاء الله regarding the myth about depression. Some people believe that the more you talk about depression, it's bad. So what you do is that you just suppress it and don't talk about it. Only that is wrong. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was an approachable man. And people would go to him with all their issues. Oh Prophet Allah, I'm depressed. Never the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, oh be quiet, don't talk about that, that's bad. No, the Prophet sallallahu would hear people out. Well, what is it? What ideas do I have? Maybe sometimes in the sharing itself, there is a relief that people feel. But the point is, please do not believe it. When people say the more you talk about depression, the worse it makes it, that is not acceptable. Last point, especially for the young people who are present. If one of your friends comes to you and they tell you that I have been thinking about doing something to myself, please tell people, tell his parents or her parents. This is not the time to say, I am a loyal friend. When people trust me with their secrets, I don't tell out. Please don't do that. تأمل معي في كلام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال المجالس بالأمانات ما لم يحدثك الرجل بقتل أو بأكل أموال الناس بالباطل. صلوا على رسول الله. He said that every gathering is confidential unless somebody tells you about killing, be it themselves or somebody else, or devouring the people's wealth in vain. At that point, there is no respect for confidentiality. Tell somebody about it. Tell other friends. Tell his or her parents. Because we want people to get involved. As many and as much resources to this person so that inshallah they overcome the difficulties that they have. يقول الإمام الشافعي يا صاحب الهم أبشر بخير يا شاكي الهم إن الهم منفرج أبشر بخير فإن الفارج الله اليأس يقطع أحيانا بصاحبه لا تيأسن فإن الفارج الله فثق بالله وارض به فإن الكافي هو الله والله ما لك غير الله من أحد فحسبك الله في كل لك الله. هذا كلام جميل. Said that Imam Shafi'i is telling people that, you know what, yes, the difficulties are there, but always remember that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is in charge. And knowing that Allah is in charge is something that brings about peace into our hearts. Finally, depression is contagious. What do I mean? If you're depressed, it will affect on your family. If the father or the mother, if they're depressed, wallahi, it spreads in the family. We think that contagious diseases are about virus and bacteria. Yes, they are. But sometimes the mood, if you come and meet somebody who's just giggly and happy all the time, you know, automatically you start giggling and laughing as well. But if you come around a person and they're just absolutely gloomy and doomy and depressed, again, at least for the sake of sympathy, we would do that along with them. So please, inshallah, remember, the sooner you get help, the sooner you get better, the sooner, and inshallah, you do not affect your families. And finally, please do make use of our organization at Access, where we have qualified counselors who can help. And like we say all the time, all of our services are confidential, and these are people who are qualified to help, and if they are unable to help, inshallah, they will lead you and they will guide you. They will give you referral to somebody who is more capable than we are to extend the help for you. Remember two people, please, the people of Gaza. Today is the 1000th day of the blockade against the people of Gaza. And what is happening against them is inhumane, it is uncivilized, and of all people, we would not expect it from the victims of the Holocaust. If you yourself have been a victim, you cannot be the party who is guilty of victimizing these people. So please do keep them in your prayers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make out for them. Because they're being deserted by all their neighbors, and the people who are putting the blockades on them, Allah has snatched mercy out of their hearts. You've got to be a person with no heart to be doing this to the people of Gaza. And if you are a neighbor, and you're even participating furthermore in this blockade, subhanAllah, it just leaves me speechless what to say about that. So please, even though we can't really do anything to them, the least that we can do is to keep them in our prayers. So please do keep them in your prayers. And also the Muslim community lost a very beautiful member in the national arena, and that is Sister Amina Salami. She passed away about 10 days ago in a car accident. Amina Salami, for those of you who don't know her, is a revert to Islam, and she was very active in spreading the word of Islam. In fact, she was actually coming from a lecture when she got into the accident. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless her soul, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make her final abode paradise, ya Rabbil Alameen. اللهم يا رب فرج همنا وهم المهمومين ونفس كربنا وكرب المكروبين واقض عنا الدين وعن المدينين. اللهم يا رب ارحم موتانا واشف مرضانا وفك اسرانا وعاف مبتلانا. اللهم عاف مبتلانا. اللهم يا رب عاف مبتلانا واختم بالصالحات الباقيات اجالنا. اللهم يا رب بعلمك الغيب وقدرتك على الخلق احينا ما كانت الحياه خيرا لنا وتوفنا ما كانت الوفاه خيرا لنا. اللهم اجعل خير اعمالنا خواتيمها وخير ايامنا يوم نلقاك برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله اكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. واقم الصلاه.